SpaceX and Blue Origin have been competing with each other for many spacecrafts and commercial contracts. Both the companies are developing their next-generation rocket, but SpaceX is the leading space company, has made many rocket engines since its launch in 2002. A little over 2 years Blue Origin's rocket engines development started, work on the BE-4 engine since 2011. Importantly, they said the BE-4 would be ready for flight by 2017, but at this very moment Blue Origin's powerful BE-4 engine is more than 4 years late. As Blue Origin nears the critical point of delivering flight-ready BE-4 rocket engines to United Launch Alliance, the engineer in charge of the company's rocket engine program has decided to leave. Blue Origin CEO Bob Smith recently informed employees of the departure of John Vilja, the senior vice president of Blue Engines. In Smith's email to employees, Vilja is said to be leaving Blue to pursue his many interests and hobbies outside of work. During his time at Blue, John led the team to support 8 new Shepard missions, powered by BE-3 PM engines, countless hot fire tests, and made progress on multiple engines development programs, Smith wrote. He also built a world-class engines team, recruiting some of the best talent in the business. Sources familiar with Vilja's work confirm that he was a good manager and engineer, who helped get the BE-4 rocket engine program back on track. As reported last August, before Vilja's arrival, the numerous challenges faced by the engineers and technicians working to build and test BE-4 development engines included being hardware poor. During his tenure, Vilja hired Linda Kova to serve as his deputy. She will now lead, at least on an interim basis, the engines team at Blue Origin. Kova came to the company in 2021 after working on various propulsion programs at Aerojet Rocketdyne for 35 years. Among her duties, she led the development of the AR-1 engine, which lost out to the BE-4 engine in a competition held by United Launch Alliance for its new Vulcan rocket. The BE-4 engine gone through almost a decade of failure, this was their first engine to combust liquid oxygen and liquefied natural gas propellants. It was initially planned for the engine to be used exclusively on a Blue Origin proprietary launch vehicle New Glenn, the company's first orbital rocket. However, it was announced in 2014 that the engine would also be used on the United Launch Alliance Vulcan Centaur launch vehicle. The successor to the Atlas VERSUS launch vehicle, this was labeled a stunner choice. The company planned to begin full-scale engine testing in late 2016 and expected to complete the development of the engine in 2017. However, the first engine was not fully assembled until March 2017. Also in March, United Launch Alliance indicated that the economic risk of the Blue Origin engine selection option had been retired, but that the technical risk on the project would remain until a series of engine firing tests were completed later in 2017. A test anomaly occurred on the 13th of May 2017, and Blue Origin reported that they lost a set of power pack hardware. Blue Origin BE-4 rocket engine power head and combustion chamber was the first BE-4 engine to be hot fire tested. The test occurred on the 18th of October in 2017. Finally, in July of 2020, the first Pathfinder BE-4 was delivered to United Launch Alliance for integration testing with the Vulcan Centaur in August of 2020. It was not immediately clear why Vilja left Blue Origin with the end of the BE-4 development program in sight. However, a Blue Origin spokesperson said, Vilja's departure would have no effect on the production of BE-4 engines. According to company sources, the first two BE-4 flight engines are in final production at Blue Origin's factory in Kent, Washington. The first of these engines is scheduled to be shipped to a test site in May for acceptance testing to ensure its flight readiness. A second should follow in reasonably short order. On this schedule, Blue Origin could conceivably deliver both flight engines to United Launch Alliance in June or July. Sources at Blue Origin and United Launch Alliance say development versions of the BE-4, which are nearly identical to the flight versions, have been performing well in tests. Upon receiving the engines, United Launch Alliance plans to install two of the BE-4 engine on the Vulcan rocket for a debut launch as soon as possible. While at the Satellite 2022 conference in the District of Columbia, United Launch Alliance CEO Tory Bruno on Tuesday said, he still anticipates that Vulcan's debut launch will occur in 2022. However, a summertime delivery would be a very tight schedule for United Launch Alliance. There is increasing pressure to demonstrate the readiness of Vulcan, which will carry a small lunar mission for Astrobotic on its first launch. Originally scheduled to debut in 2020, Vulcan is expected to play a major role in U.S. national security launches during the mid-2020s. However, due to delays, the U.S. Space Force has already had to move the first military mission assigned to Vulcan, designated USSF-51, onto an Atlas V rocket. The war in Ukraine has added further incentive to get Vulcan flying. The Atlas V, which uses Russian-made Rode 180 engines, has a finite amount of missions remaining before it retires. The U.S. military is eager to move its missions to vehicles made in the United States. At present, the only alternative the U.S. Space Force has for medium and heavy lift is the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets, built by SpaceX, which use American-made Merlin engines. Sources say there recently was a relatively small production issue, with the fabrication of the flight engines at Blue Origin's factory in Kent, Washington. As a result, the engines will not be completed and shipped to the company's test stands in West Texas until next year. Once there, each engine must be unpacked, tested and then reconfigured to move to LA Rocket Assembly Facility in northern Alabama, reasonable no earlier than date for the engines. Arrival at the rocket manufacturer is now April of 2022, and this assumes a smooth final production and testing phase. But as we all know, manufacturing engines is very difficult and would require a lot of investment. Even though SpaceX is now in a Raptor engine crisis, Jeff Bezos still has a lot of work to catch up on. This is truly a dire situation, and how did LA react to this continuous delay? What was Tony Bruno's plan, and how will it change you? ULA declined to comment on specifics about the production issue. People had often seen that Tony Bruno always covered for Jeff at many previous delays. However, the company now said it was disappointed that it did not receive these two flight engines in 2021. As anticipated, we are disappointed that we will not be receiving Vulcan flight engines from Blue Origin by the end of the year, but they will be arriving early next year, the company said in a statement. The certification program is moving along very well, and the production engines are being manufactured. We look forward to Vulcan's first launch in 2022. However, it now seems far from certain that Vulcan will make its debut in 2022, and there is a lot riding on this rocket and its timely debut, which will replace both the Atlas and Delta rockets that ULA has flown. The U.S. military is counting on Vulcan to lift about 60% of the nation's national security payloads into space from 2022 to 2027. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.